in a Saturday, Sept. 23, 2017 photo. Police make several arrests of people protesting the Sept. 15 acquittal of former police officer Jason Stockley in the death of a black man at the street. Louis Galleria, Christian Gooden, St. Louis Post-Dispatch via AP. St. Louis. Several elected officials and faith leaders on Monday called for an investigation into the way police arrested and incarcerated protesters at a suburban Sept. Louis mall, with many referring to the altercation as a police riot. Police from both agencies involved in the arrests defended officers' actions, saying demonstrators got out of hand Saturday at the Sept. Louis Galleria in Richmond Heights, Missouri, and officers had no choice but to take some of them to the ground. The protest was among many in Sept. Louis and its suburbs since a judge ruled in mid-September that former police officer Jason Stockley was not guilty of first-degree murder in the death of Anthony Lamar Smith, a black suspect. Nearly 200 people have been arrested since the Sept. 15 ruling. Among them were 22 people arrested at the Galleria. A police riot broke out. But let me be clear, it was terrorism. The Rev. Karen Anderson of Ward Chapel Aim Church in Florissant said at a news conference involving about 36 people, including pastors, a rabbi and state lawmakers. She and several other speakers urged an investigation of the way police are handling protesters through the U.S. Department of Justice, the Missouri legislature or some other body. Those arrested included a 13-year-old boy and the Rev. Kayla Fry of Sept. Peter Aim Church in Sept. Louis. Fry did not participate in the news conference, which was held at her church. She and six other protesters were charged with rioting and resisting arrest after Saturday's demonstration. Fry was also charged with assault for allegedly jumping on the back of a police officer. The other 15 people arrested were referred to Richmond Heights Municipal Court for charges. The protest began with about 150 people marching through the upscale mall. Things took a turn when protesters blocked an escalator and sought to go the second floor against the wishes of mall management. Police said someone threw a trash can at officers. Richmond Heights Capt. Jerry Rohr used a bullhorn to order the crowd to disperse. He said he issued the same warning two more times over several minutes as Sept. Louis County Police arrived to assist. Marjorie Theodore, who was at the protest, told reporters Monday that there was so much noise Saturday that she couldn't make out what was said over the bullhorn. Her 33-year-old son was among those arrested. A Sept. Louis Post-Dispatch photographer took pictures showing Fry on the back of a Sept. Louis County officer as he appeared to be making an arrest. Another picture showed Fry being arrested. Some said the second photo showed her being choked by an officer. Rohr and Sept. Louis County Police spokesman Sean McGuire deny Fry was choked. They said the photo showed a Richmond Heights officer pulling her away from the county officer she had jumped on, a man who is still off work with a back injury that resulted. McGuire said, when she jumps on the back of a police officer while effecting an arrest, that's an assault, McGuire said. Rohr said the photo was misleading. She was not placed in a chokehold. Rohr said, that's burst photography. I guarantee the officer was trying to push that woman away and get her under control. Police tactics also were questioned on Sept. 17 in Sept. Louis, when more than 120 people were arrested after windows were broken at several businesses. Some of those arrested for failure to disperse were just onlookers, including a Post-Dispatch journalist, an Air Force officer and an undercover police officer. The Post-Dispatch reported, __ sign up for the app's weekly newsletter showcasing our best reporting from the Midwest and Texas. http://opni.ws2u1rmfv